Hey everybody, Tony D and Little Joan here on a hot take, and our hot take's going to be hashtag Bernie or bust and the various hashtags for the Bernie bros trying to cope with their the destruction of their candidate. Sorry, Bernie bros, but we tried to tell you. We tried to warn you, right, Little Joan? Right, Little Joan? Oh, Little Joan sleepy. Little Joan had a big day sleeping. Little Joan feels bad for you, Bernie Browns. I pet Little Joan on your behalf. There you go. There you go. Let's see what people are saying in the Bernie world. This is Bernie or Bust hashtag. Grandma Nixon says, my entire family just did a Dem exit. You should do the same. Biden is going to get crushed in November, and it's all thanks to the Democratic establishment and billionaires who pulled their strings. Wake up, America. Yeah, that's relatively true. Oh, there's another hashtag, burn it down. Let's take a look at that one. Burn it down. Let's see. My package arrived just in time. I assume this is some sort of Bernie sign. I'm going to turn the sound down in case there's music. I don't think there is. This is Matt Russell, who's taking too long to get to this gag. I'm going to just zoom ahead. Yeah, Bernie 2020. Yep, I figured that's what it was. Bernie Nation, they need us, says, what Bernie is about to start saying about Joe Biden. Understand, he's saying it, but he knows what that we all know of the critiques that he's levied against Joe Biden has not gone away. Going away. It was a very confusing post. He knows that we're not going to support this guy. Well, it seems like you are a mind reader, Bernie Nation. The Fifth Horseman says, time to burn it down. I disagree with that. Burn being spelled B-E-R-N. Sean King, he's retweeting Sean King. Breaking, we are on call with Bernie Sanders right now, and he just told us that he's stepping down from the presidential race. He'll be going live in a public few minutes. We did our best. He did our best. Our movement for deep, systematic change moves forward. If you're going to use somebody like Sean King, I don't think you're going to get very far. No offense. Celeste McCormick, not me, us, says, I need one effing good thing to happen in my life, and that is to see Bernie win this nomination, no matter how hard the DNC, Trump, and Biden apologists try to stop us. Progressive policies or burn it down. It seems extreme. Thank you, Bernie, says, I don't even know what his avatar is. It's crazy that this one sane, truly decent person in Washington is also most hated person there. Almost like liberal democracy is a sham or something. Burn it down. I don't think that's true at all. Thomas Massey recently voted against the stimulus. I think he took a principled stance. I don't even think he voted against it, but he did call for a vote, which I think was important. It depends on what your priorities are, Bernie bros. I mean, if your priority is sitting at home with UBI, then I guess we know what your priorities are. You want to be taken care of. Mommy can't take care of you, Bernie bros. Considering this is democracy, says Comrade Virus PDX, I didn't even get a chance to vote for a candidate yet. I honestly likely won't. F the DNC, burn it down. I don't know what that means. Are you too young to vote? Dan Watson, I guess Trump just locked in my protest vote. At Joe Biden, you have 7 months to convince me otherwise. He also says, I pledge to vote and campaign for Trump, barring concessions from Biden or Medicare for all. You're not going to get that. We can't afford it. I don't know why you people can't do math. We can't afford Medicare for all. If you give everybody in the United States Medicare, what you will get is you will get urgent care for everybody. And urgent care means, yes, it will be free to take care of your bumps and bruises, to take care of a broken leg, and to get your cold and flu medicine. But when you get cancer, when you get something serious, you're effed. You're effed, okay? Just ask an older person in Canada. Okay, ask someone who's in Canada waiting on chemotherapy. Ask someone in a foreign country who came here for better health care. Socialized medicine is not the answer. It's not the answer. Look, my hospital, before the Obamacare, did charity care. And I had it because I'm broke. I'm always broke. I had to prove how much money I had in the bank and how much money I essentially made, I think. I know I had to prove how much money I didn't have in the bank, basically. And once I proved that, they gave me a card and I had charity care. And they charged me basically something I could afford. So I wouldn't get, it wouldn't be totally free. I would have to pay for certain things. Like I didn't have to pay for the doctor, but I'd have to pay for like a splint when I hurt my wrist. I had my gallbladder out. The head of surgery volunteered to do it. I had to pay for the anesthesia. That was like $2,500. And they worked out a payment plan with me. You can work it out. These people want to help you. But you keep wanting to put it in the hands of bureaucrats. Bureaucrats don't want to help you, okay? You're upset with the government. You're upset with Trump. Even if you got a guy like Bernie, let's say, you elect a guy like Bernie, and he gives you all these great things. Do you want a guy like Trump running your healthcare right now? Do you? Do you want the guy in charge to be a guy like Trump? Because that's what would eventually happen. Eventually, a Republican or someone close to a Republican would get elected. And then you'd be effed, okay? Because then he'd try to balance the budget as much as he can or shift the money away from Medicare. And then you'd be screwed. Because then you'd go into, and by the time you correct it again, you're already dead or injured or whatever. Okay? You don't want the Leviathan, that's the United States government, taking everything on. It already takes on too much. I don't even know why I'm talking to you people. All right. Other than burn it down, what else do we have here trending? Let's see. Had some other interesting ones. Let me get back to the home front here. Oh, never Biden, never Trump. Here we go. These are the top. Yellow Vest America, you don't have to vote for Joe over and over again, yeah. Joe offers leftists nothing. He's not owed a damn thing. I mostly agree with that. Bernie Run Green, Justice for Tara, says, I am furious at the Democratic Party. I hate the Republican Party, too. However, they never pretended to represent me. F them both. No party that sends voters to die during a pandemic or nominates a rapist deserves to exist. Both have done both. I'm not really totally following that logic, but your illustration's very funny. Very funny. Becca says, I will not vote for a lying, senile, corrupt, racist, rapist, period, T. Never Biden, never Trump. Hello, Green Party, again. Well, again, Bernie should have went to the Green Party the first time if he hadn't endorsed Hillary Clinton and completely S'd the bed. Furman, or Fermin, my message to every burner being voter shamed right now by these S libs.
Democrats, you don't have to vote for Joe Biden. You don't have to vote for Joe Biden. You don't have to vote for Joe Biden. Because even if he's the nominee and you don't align with him morally, you don't have to vote for him.
Okay, that's true. Lefty, capitalism kills. Please unfollow me immediately if you're going to vote for Biden. See, these are the kinds of people that really, they're just annoying. Because it's not enough that they don't get their way. They also have to control you. They also have to give you instructions on how to live and do things. F you, lefty. Bernie or else, I don't vote for rapists or conservatives, so you'll never get my vote, Joe. Retweet if you won't vote for Joe Biden. Abby Hale, the Green Party right now after seeing never Biden, never Trump trending on Twitter. It's a kid with a drink and a gun. I got to turn that off because of the music. I assume the gun goes off and scares the hell out of him. CB 2020 for U.S. House. I'm not okay switching one corrupt pea grabber for another, are you? The lesser of two evils isn't evil, never Biden, never Trump. Is this someone actually running? Huh. Yeah, she's running in Oregon. That sounds like a place where you can get elected as a radical leftist. Austin says, do you want proof that the MSN and social platforms are censoring content exposing Biden? You literally cannot find this video unless you have the link to it. Will not come up in the search options. These are seriously dark times. Yes, and it's a shame a lot of you radical leftists didn't get want freedom of speech. Many of you fought against freedom of speech, and if you fight for it, if you fight to censor some people, you will yourself be censored. It's as simple as that. You are dummies. You are dummies who couldn't see the writing on the wall, and you still can't. All right, let's see what else we got in the way of Never Trump, Bernie or Bus. Bernie dropout was another one. Me giving my vote to Biden just so we could beat Trump, says KC. Ha ha, very funny. Claudie says, bro, why the F are Americans so stupid? Bernie effing Sanders literally existed. I don't know what that means. I guess they're saying we should... Some foreigner saying I should vote for Bernie. No, thank you. I live in the greatest country in the world. Where do you live, foreigner? Aisha, Bernie has been fighting his whole life for this, and America couldn't see that compassion. I'm heartbroken.
Wah, wah.
Oh, music again. Can't play that. Alicia is... I'm actually so upset. Bernie has spent his entire life fighting for equal rights. He deserved this much more than anyone else. Look, Bernie made the calls, good calls, early in his life. He supported civil rights. He supported rights for gay and lesbian people, and I applaud him for that. But you know what? Black Lives Matter didn't know their history when they interrupted him on stage and humiliated him in 2016 trying to give a speech. And where was the defense of Bernie then? You guys didn't come out then. You guys didn't defend him. You should have went after, the black people who support Bernie Sanders should have said to Black Lives Matter, no, that was not cool. You went after an ally, you humiliated him, and that wasn't cool. That would have been the smart thing to do. No one really did it, okay? No one really did it. Sam Castillo, me after I saw Bernie dropped out. Oh, poor guy. Lisa says, me wondering how April 2020 was going to screw us over. April, Joe Biden or Donald Trump for president? Me trying to still pick Bernie. That's a pretty funny meme. Now the leftists are good at memes. Sergal. Bernie will remain on the ballot, so you can still vote for him, and you should. The only thing that's changing is, one, Bernie is shifting his focus to more immediate crisis relief work. Two, Bernie will not encourage people to risk their lives for a vote. I don't know if you could really speak for Bernie that much, but I guess. You should vote who you feel is the best candidate, regardless of their current situation. As a libertarian, I feel your pain in that respect. Ebbs say, Bernie dropout. Bernie just dropped out, and he's already trending as if this was a sign that people actually liked him or talked about him. At his age, he is still fought for what is right. Thank you, Bernie. It sucks you could never put that passion into changing America. Olivia Robinson says, realizing we're either going to be stuck with dumb, dumb, bubblegum, dusty, crusty Trump or the wet sock that is Joe Biden. Please don't scream. Oh, just crying. Don't want to see the scream. FU says, Bernie drops out of the race and now supporters say they won't vote. How about you back up the Democratic Party to get Trump out? I don't know. Trump seems to be doing a good job. Abby says, Bernie gave me hope that this country could get better and now we are stuck voting between two people I don't give an F about the people of this country. Who don't give an F about the people of this country. Bernie meme, I'm once again asking, is it ever going to get any better? Look, Trump is, he's a tough guy to like. But he's doing pretty good. Look, he's not torching the country. He hasn't done anything an 80s Democrat wouldn't do. And he's not a radical leftist. He's giving you free money. I mean, my God, he's spending more money than any president ever. There's plenty of things to criticize Trump, but you have to understand economics, and you guys just don't. You think the money is endless. It's not. Trump's going to prove that, maybe. We have to pay our bills. You have to pay your bills. And you have to work, and you have to do things. I mean, it's just the reality of math. So, I'm sorry, but Bernie's done. And Bernie never stood a chance. Only 25% of the Democratic Party really supported Bernie, and the rest were kind of along the run. You know, he had a good base within the Democrats. And because there were so many people on stage, his hardcore support put him in the lead. That's the only reason. Had there just been Bernie, say Bernie, Biden, and like Warren, if that had been the case the entire time, same thing would have played out. Okay? Same thing would have played out. Had Warren not been in there, would he have beaten Biden? Maybe. But the Democratic establishment doesn't want you. Never wanted you. They just want your votes. Okay? I know what that's like as a libertarian. The Republican Party did the same thing to us. They said the same thing to us. Who do you want? Do you want Obama? You got to vote for Mitt Romney. And we said no. We stood our ground. And people called us all sorts of names for it. They're going to call you a bunch of names. So what? Go into the Green Party, go into the Socialist Party, go into the Communist Party, and do your work there. And if your ideas are good, one day you may gain some footing in the power structure here. But until that day, you have to work. Sorry, no one's going to give it to you. Anyhow, sorry, Bernie Bros. It's over. It's over, Johnny. It's over.